Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 26 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I introduced you to metastrips, but today I want to talk about keyframes again. Now, I talked about keyframes for the first time in video 18, so you can go over there and watch that video if you want a more comprehensive explanation of how keyframes work. But I think the problem with that video was that it made us look at so many different windows, like the graph editor and the dope sheet, that it might have made some people think that dealing with keyframes was actually just too complicated for them. Today I want to show you that you don't have to use the graph editor, you don't have to use the dope sheet in order to actually insert keyframes and erase keyframes. It's really easy to use keyframes on your strips. So what better way to demonstrate that than to show you guys how to do a fade in from black using keyframes instead of doing it the way that I taught you in a previous video, which showed you how to do it using a gamma cross effect. So let me show you how you do a gamma cross fade in first and show you why it's not really the best way to do it. So let's go down to our add menu, go to effect strip, and we're gonna lay down a color strip. Now, the way that you do a gamma cross fade in is we right click on our color strip, we hold our shift button down to group select, and we right click on our footage that we want to fade into. We go to the add menu, effect strip, and we do a gamma cross. Now you can see it actually generated this gamma cross layer right here. What I want to do now is show you guys a feature that I only discovered probably in the last 5 or so months, and I use it all the time. And that is this little feature down here in the frame menu. It's called Set Preview Range. And this allows us to repeat play a small segment of our video. And it doesn't change the render frame range. It just allows us to kind of cache the footage and watch it over and over again to see the changes that require a caching of video in order to see them. So in this case, we're going to hit the P button and draw a square over the area we want to render over and over again, and hit the play button, and you'll see it's going to play this over and over again, and you can see it's doing the fade in as we would think it should. Okay, so what's the problem with doing a fade in using the gamma cross? Well, the problem is that it links the color strip and the footage together. So we can't put anything in between them. And this is a problem if you have transparent images that you want to cover parts of your footage, that you want to be seen beneath the fade, but above the footage. Or sometimes you'll have titles, and when you're fading in, you want to be able to see the titles over the footage while you fade in. So let me show you. I have a green arrow over here that has a transparent background. I'm going to try to put this arrow underneath this gamma crossed fade in and show you how it ignores this. So let's take these two strips. I'm going to move them up, and I'm going to grab this and I'm going to move it to the first frame. And we're going to play this over and over again. By doing the preview range, it's going to always recache. So we're going to see the change. As you can see, it's not showing the arrow at all. It's because it completely ignores it when you do a gamma cross. It only looks at the color strip and the footage, and it crosses between those, ignores everything in between. So that's not going to work for us if we need to have transparent PNGs above our footage and below a fade in. So let me move the arrow out of the way again, and we're going to delete the gamma strip and the color strip. And we're going to do it now using keyframes instead of using the gamma cross, the fade in, that is. So let's put this on frame one and go to add effect strip. And we're going to add a color strip again. And now just make sure that your color strip is selected by right clicking on it, and make sure you're on frame one. Go over to the opacity setting. It's set to 1, which means full visibility. And we're going to insert a keyframe into it by holding the cursor over the property and hitting I. And you'll notice that it turned yellow. That's Blender's way of saying a keyframe has been inserted into this property. So now all I need to do is hold my cursor over the VSE, push the page up button, and that jumps us to each segment break or whatever. And now all I have to do is set this opacity to 0 and hit I, and we now have a transition that we can actually see. So let's actually watch this over and over again. Give it a second to cache. There we go. So now you can see there's a fade in, but this time it's using keyframes on the opacity instead of actually linking the color strip to the footage. And the advantage of this is that I can now grab this color strip that has the keyframes in the opacity. I can pull it up. I can grab this transparent PNG. I can put it right underneath, and you can see, I'm going to play it back, you can already see it. So look, let's hit the refresh sequencer button. Whenever you get these little glitches, by the way, like jumping, that means that you need to hit the refresh sequencer button and force it to recache everything again. So it's going to play through a couple times, and you can see that it's doing the fade in, and it's also honoring the fact that there is a image strip below the color strip that has transparent background. So there you go. That is an easy way to create a fade in that allows you to have transparent PNGs under it. It's also better because all of the keyframes are linked to this one strip. So no matter where I put it, I'm gonna hit my P button again, and we're gonna draw this section to play this over. And I'm gonna hit play, or hit refresh sequencer, and place the green light inside of there, hit play. And you're gonna see that it does the fade in from a different location. It's not locked to one position in my project. So now the question you might have is, well, I created keyframes, how do I get rid of them? Well, you can simply get rid of keyframes by right-clicking on the strip that has keyframes inserted into them, and you can see the green here, that means that there's keyframes in it. Right-click on this property, and there's an option that says clear keyframes. Once I do that, it deletes all the keyframes for that strip, and it just becomes a regular color strip again. So you can start all over again. You can use page up and page down buttons to set this keyframe here, page up, set this to 0, insert keyframe, and now we have a working fade again that's mobile. So it's way better, in my personal opinion, to use a fade with keyframes rather than a gamma cross. I will see you guys in the next video.